Is it hate speech or free speech? Killing Jews is worship. Draws us closer to Allah.
Also ahead, should a sign that says killing Jews is worship be allowed on New York City buses? We'll debate it.
Unresolved problem segment tonight, free speech versus threatening behavior. Federal judge has ruled that a poster saying killing Jews is worship can be put up as an advertisement on New York City buses. The ad is by a pro-Israel group. It says it wants to raise awareness of how dangerous Muslim terrorism is. But that might be lost in the headline, which is provocative in the extreme. Joining us now from Washington, Fox News senior judicial analyst, Judge Andrew Napolitano. Well,
this sign, I mean, is very provocative. And then if you read the small print, you know, it's about people who don't like Muslim terrorists and the jihad. But the headline, killing Jews is worship, is what everybody is going to see because the buses go by real fast. It's not like right. You have time to read the whole damn sign. Right. And you got a jihadist right. there and all of that. And you know, some people say, look, you know, people are going to say this is a threat. And you say?
I agree with the judge. Listen, this is not an easy case. The speech is hateful and repellent and certainly provocative. But under the law, it does not qualify as hate speech. Hate speech, which is unprotected, is speech which provokes a particular individual to engage in immediate violence. Look, if these signs start provoking people to engage in immediate violence, the court's going to have to relook at it. But the sign standing alone, as hateful as that language is, does not meet the hate speech standard.
Okay, so it's only if there is an immediate danger caused by an action of expression that the government can come in and stop it.
Yes. And right. The reason for that is because the First Amendment presumes that all speech, even speech we hate and don't want to hear, is protected. So the government has the burden of showing that it's unprotected, and it hasn't met that burden here.
All right. Because now, the government let me give you a buses. Hypothetical because I want everybody to understand. Say some loon runs out on the streets of New York or Washington, D.C. in 5 minutes and start screaming, I want to kill all Jews. All Jews should die. Can the police stop that man?
No. The police could stop him if the mobs began to respond to him.
Well, they might beat him up. I mean, he might get attacked.
Well, now you're talking about the mob silencing him because they don't like what he said.
Right.
The police obligation, believe it or not, in that hypothetical would be to protect him from the mob,
yes,
but not to silence
him. So you can go out and you can call for the death of anybody you want, but unless there's some action surrounding it, no one can stop you.
That's the current state of First Amendment jurisprudence with respect to provocative speech. Yes, Bill.
All right, Judge. Thanks very much. When we come right back, did you know